Hello, I'm Irene Natividad. I'm president of the Global Summit of Women, which will be taking place here in Bangkok, Thailand. As a lead up to that, I want you to understand that one of the facts about Thailand is that there is a great number of women in charge in business, and I want you to meet one of them today. We are here with Khun Priyanat, who is the CEO of Bigrim Power, one of the largest energy producers in Thailand. So welcome. So you have been with Bigrim Power now for many years.
Yes, actually I've been in Bigrim Group for 28 years.
My goodness.
Yes, and we just found the Bigrim Power since the beginning 25 years ago. So it is one of the very first private power producer in Thailand.
You know, there are not many women in the field of energy. What led you to, you know, this field of power generation? What was your training that led you to that?
Actually, I think that is somehow I'm so lucky. Because
it has nothing to do with luck. Being head of a major company has nothing to do with luck.
It's luck. Let me explain. Because when we just start this Bigrim Power, this energy company, is just before financial crisis, and at that time, in charge as the CFO of Bigrim Group, and you know, it will be so challenged at that time, and because Bigrim Group at that time only expand a lot, and core business is the exporter. When we start this energy business, which we believe that it should be very long term and in suit with the Bigrim culture, and it's the opportunity just newly opened because it's the first time that the government allowed the private sector to just develop power sector. So we can.
So you're saying you were in the right place at the right time?
Yes, exactly. And we have to work hard throughout the crisis. And the key how to make the project successful is, of course, the project financing.
Yes.
And because of the, how to be Bigrim. It made our partner really trust us. So we got the support, full support from Siemens as a supplier, and also KfW, which is the state bank in Germany, and also Bangkok Bank at the time. So once that we can found the company and get the good condition from a supplier and get the financing from a very good bank, that's why we can make that first project
successful.
Successful even during the crisis.
Did you put together that combination of partners as chief financial officer?
Well, actually, Mr. Halloween, he is the chairman.
Yes.
So he has to found that, but with the support of a project financing is me and my team, and that is the key because for project financing during that time it's just most difficult, and we can just be the leader because of that. And after that, I also can get involved in the as a COO
and growing the business.
Yes, and the COO, we have to also manage the operation.
Yes.
And from the first successful project, we have now 48 projects.
Wow.
Together, because we just get a very successful story for over 20 years, and then we can go to the stock market 2 years ago.
And an IPO was done?
Yes.
Yes, congratulations. you didn't tell me, what was in your training previously? Were you in engineering or?
No.
No, tell us.
Well, I got the degree in the financing and also accounting, and also a master's degree also in business administration from Chulalongkorn University. And I think for the experience, we don't have to just stick with the skill we learn, but just make us have some basic concept good enough, because finally, when we are in the management level, the skill which is the key is how to manage the right people to the right job.
What do you feel that you brought to the position that enabled the company to grow as much as it has, not only here but also across borders? Was it strictly financial skills, people management skills, or sort of the combination?
I think it's combination, and I think the key again is about the culture and the people. So our staff, we have so many good staff, and we have a really professional team. And when you ask my staff, what do you feel to work with this company? I think most of them will say that I feel happy.
That's quite a compliment.
That's it.
Yeah.
So if you can encourage people to just work, when they just wake up in the morning and they just...
They want to go to work?
Yes, yes. And they can deliver the...
Yeah, but the CEO has a lot to do with that.
Yes.
Can I just ask, has Bigrim Power moved to alternative energy as opposed to fossil fuel?
Yes, of course. I think the right strategy is also the key, the other key, because we move to from gas to alternative energy already about 6 years ago.
Oh,
also the right time. So now we have solar, wind, hydro, all together is about 30% of portfolio. And we have now in operation about 3,000 megawatts.
Wow.
Yes.
That is impressive.
Yes.
So were you the eldest in your family, and were you always encouraged to excel?
Yes, you're right. That's good. I'm the eldest.
Of course you're the eldest. It's the usual pattern.
Yes, that's right. So feel have to responsible about everything, the whole family. And, so in the school, always you be the leader. It's like
and
that.
And your parents encouraged that?
Yes.
Yeah. Right. Father, mother?
Also from my name, Priyana. Priya is mean the, we love, and Nath is mean the rely on. The people can
rely on you.
And yes, the we love reliability or something like that.
How did your own family deal with your the pressures of the job that you've had for now almost 30 years?
Also very good question. Well, actually, I have to admit that it's always have to choose in life. And when my children were very young, we are very, very busy. I was so busy of how to just solve the crisis problem and how to manage energy business, which is new and there is big challenge. So I really have not much time for the children. So the family is not so successful. I have to divorce. But however, I think whenever we have time, we also try to bond together, because my children, now they also understand my job, and they also love to just to be beside
to
me.
To be together.
To be together. So actually, Well, and I'm very lucky because they are good kids and they are quite successful. They also obtained their master's degree and have a good job. So.
No parent ever feels that they have done the best job possible, but you excelled in your field. I'm sure they are proud of you. We are proud of you.
Thank you.
So this is Priya Dutt, who is one of the business leaders who will be coming to the Global Summit of Women, and you will hear more from people like her. So come again.